Welcome back to another Tech Saturday. Today I want to tell you all about a new light that I've been using in my office that's pretty portable and small, but yet really powerful when you actually want to use it. It's this one, the one that's lighting me. The Falcon Eyes RX-24TDX2. Pretty sweet little light. I guess it's not little, but pretty sweet. So you may remember that about 2 years ago, maybe even 3 years ago, I did a review on a fold-up LED light. I'm a huge fan of little fold-up type of lights because they are so small and easy to transport, and yet they can produce a good amount of light. And I've still been using that light a ton for random shoots. It's one that we just keep in a bag with us so that if we ever need light, we can use it. But when I was looking at possibly upgrading some lights, I wanted to look at something that was kind of along the lines of that option, but bigger, that would produce more light and have maybe a little bit more flexibility. And I came across this Falcon Eyes RX-24TDX light because it was made kind of the exact same way that the other one was, which could be folded, but yet it could be a lot softer than the other one, but also be a lot brighter when you actually wanted to use it. So I was intrigued by it. I'm a big fan of large lights because the larger the light, the softer you can make it and allows you to just really use it for a lot of different purposes. This one's pretty cool, so I want to tell you about it. So first off, a couple things that I really like about the light. Like I said, it's very flexible, not just in the rolling side of it, but it's flexible light that it can be used for a small amount of light just to kind of fill in light, or you can really make it as bright as you want and use it to produce a lot of light. It's all controlled by this little mechanism controller thing here. What is another very intriguing part about this light is the fact that it can be powered via battery. So we have V-mount batteries that we use for these lights, and it is super convenient because not only is the light portable and easy to bring with you, but being able to power it from a battery is awesome because you don't always have the option to plug things into power when you're on a shoot if you're out and about. And it's great being able to have a light that I can bring with me, powered up on a battery. It'll last for hours on end. I can use it all I want and then just replace another battery. Or when I do have a power outlet nearby, I can just plug it in. It makes it nice and convenient and quick to use. I love battery powered options on lights because convenience. Super simple to operate too. You have a dimming switch, which just basically makes the light brighter or darker. What I currently had, which is only 5% of the actual light power, where I can bring it all the way up and completely blow out myself in the camera, but that's 100%. It's really bright. That's with the big diffusion panel on, and you could take that off and that 100% power becomes even more insane and bright and blows out everything. So a lot of power this thing can produce. It also has your Kelvin ability so that you can make it much warmer or much cooler, obviously, more daylight balance, which is normally what I use in this room, so you can make it match the lights that you're trying to use, which I like a lot. You also have all these additional scenes where you can make it look like fire or make it look like a TV or whatever. I personally have never used those. I don't really know a lot of people that do, but maybe it'd be convenient. But you do have that option. They also can be controlled via DMX, which is actually really nice because if you are trying to put these on like a DMX panel and be able to control a bunch of these from one specific like light panel, they can be used for that, which is nice. Not all lights have that option. I really only use it from this, but you can obviously use it that way as well. What is cool is even though this unit is kind of fairly large, like this control surface is not like a small thing by any means, it's easy to just kind of mount wherever. They cleverly included this nice little handle. So I usually put this handle just right on basically the light stand so that it's kind of just nice and easy to access. But it also has this little mount on the side here, which I have mounted on the side of my desk. And then that way I can just kind of mount this, just click it right in there and have it mounted and easily accessible. You also can put that mount on the side of a C-stand or something and use it that way as well. So even though it's a little bit of a bigger actual control surface, it's easy to just put where you want and control it. So I really like that because it makes it quick and easy to access. I really like the light that it produces. It's just a very clean, nice looking light. You really have a lot of control about how much obviously you want to pour in your direction, but I feel like it's just a nice light to be able to have a very soft amount of light, or sometimes we'll use it where we'll actually point it against the wall and really brighten it up. And the amount of brightness that it can actually produce by just kind of bouncing off of things is also really, really great. It works great here in my home studio because I do a lot of Zoom calls and I do a a lot of consultations and things at my house, and I wanted to have a light specifically that could just kind of be here and always used. I've been wanting to get a light like that for a while, so I'm not having to constantly bring my lights from the office and set them up. So this has kind of stayed at my home for a while, but we use it quite a bit for actual shoots as well if we need even more light, because the fact that we can just pack it up in a bag and take it. The light comes with that whole diffusion panel that basically you can diffuse the light, but it also comes entirely with like the honeycomb grid, which allows you to kind of focus that light even more as well. I like the fact that that came with it, because it just comes with everything you need to kind of have all the flexibility you want with the light. That honeycomb thing is really nice if you're trying to not make the light flood as much into the room and you want it to be a little bit more focused on your subject. You can throw that on there, and that makes a huge difference as well. And because all the stuff is kind of made to be portable, it all just kind of rolls up and folds out of the way, so it's really quick to just put in a bag and get it out of there, and you're not necessarily having to worry about adding all this extra bulk by bringing all the accessories. All the accessories, including the light, this thing, all the additional like diffusions and honeycomb stuff, all just kind of folds up into its own bag, and it's really easy to bring with you. If I had to pick a con about this light, though, one thing I would say is that the actual setup of the light, while it's nice and small in terms of portability, it's a little bit annoying to kind of set up because of the way that they built the stand and the way that they built the diffuser. Like, it takes a little bit longer than I'd prefer, but it's a pro and a con, because the pro is they made it really portable, so it doesn't take up a lot of space when you're traveling. But because it's so portable, it's a lot of parts that kind of is a little bit more annoying to actually put together. Let me show you. So this is the light itself. As you can see, it's not a small light. It is pretty large compared to the other foldable light I used to have. And that's what I really like about it. But what's cool is that even though the light's big, it can fold down into a relatively small bag. But the problem is the way that it's actually designed is the thing that I'm not crazy about. So all of this kind of comes in multiple pieces, obviously designed for portability, but also takes a little bit of time. So let me show you how it breaks down. The diffuser is Velcroed. So the diffuser itself obviously can just get folded up nice and easy. This piece that actually holds the diffuser is also not attached to the light, because you can fold it down. So this is the piece that goes around it to actually hold the diffuser. As you can see, this folds down. And obviously, I can understand why it's built this way, so that it can be nice and portable. It just takes a little bit longer. This piece comes out. This is the frame. This breaks down here to a small little piece like this. And then this thing itself is flexible and basically folds up like this into the shell itself, into the case itself. The problem is it's a little bit of annoyance setting it all up. So you put it all in the case, and once you get it out, you basically put this here in the star pattern. You put these into these side things, which can kind of be a hassle in itself, but you put this side in here, you put an angle in here, you put this angle in here, and this is what I'm talking about. Like, it kind of is a little bit annoying. This goes into here, and when you're trying to get this one in here, you gotta like bend it a good amount, but you can't let the other side pop out or whatever. So you get the frame. We then normally would put it on like a light stand. And then on the back of the light, there's Velcro strips. And basically that's what this part goes on to. So you kind of get this thing out. There's this one part here that has like the little notch. That's where the power thing goes. Kind of have to like line it up onto the back of this. And then once that's up, then you have your shell obviously like this. This is how it looks. Then you put the diffuser here along the inside of the Velcro. And then you connect your units obviously to everything, and you plug it into power or whatever, and you're kind of ready to go. The somewhat issue we had is that we felt like sometimes it if we were just trying to set up a light quickly to be able to just fill in a little light. Some of the other lights we had were just easier to do that very quickly, like taking it out, plugging it in, turning it on and using it rather than having to set everything up. Now, granted, if you don't need the diffusion and you want to just use the light, it's pretty quick because you just put it up and you're ready to go. A lot of people will use it that way, which is fine. But I like this part about the light the best. You kind of have to set that up every single time. So even though it only takes a couple of minutes, if you're running and gunning and trying to do things quickly, it's a little bit more bulky, let's just say. But I won't even say bulky because it's still much quicker than setting up some lights and having, obviously, a lot of huge pieces that you have to transport. So overall, it still is very portable, especially for the size and for the light power and the how nice it looks. It's really, really a good light. So once it's all disassembled, you have this case, and this is what the whole thing fits into. So once again, pretty portable and small. You just put everything in there and everything kind of just stuffs in the middle of the light. So it rolls up to basically, like I said, that dimension. What is cool about it, like I said, is you also get the honeycomb. So in the same way that this one works, so this would set up just like the other light all the way around the edges. And then you got a whole honeycomb set up too. So really nice that you do get that flexibility, because being able to have those two options, which can be a very different type of light, depending on whether you're using this or the diffusion, it really is nice, because it's hard to get this much light with this kind of flexibility in this small of a design. So I will say that I'm impressed that they could make it so small. And then this is the light itself. As you can see, tons and tons of LEDs. It's built really nice. It feels very solid. It definitely feels much stronger than the previous one that we had. This is built very, very well. So it's nice and secure. It doesn't feel like it's gonna break. It's a very pretty strong material. The cables, power cables themselves are built really well. I do like also that they gave a pretty long power cable. So I don't know how long this whole thing is, but I would say probably 20 feet. If you are gonna have to run into power, you don't always need an extension cord when you have a light that long. I always like when companies give long power cables. But like I said, the biggest advantage to me of this light is that we just pop a battery right on it and we can use it with no sort of power at all. This is the Falcon Eyes RX-24TDX 2. It's the light that I use all the time in my office now. And I definitely recommend it. So hopefully this was helpful to you. If you have any questions, I'm happy to try to answer them for you, but I'll post a link down below to where you can buy it and learn more about it. If you want to know any of the other details in terms of all the other stuff that they claim that it has or whatever, I might have missed some things, but this is what I think. It's a cool light.